Hello everybody, my name is Denis and you are watching Close to Algo Trading. New Year holidays are finished and we continue our experiment. Well, it's going very slow, but still moving forwards. Today, we will have a look at our labeled data and then we will get to know the TFX pipeline. Let's go! In the previous video, we created labels. But I forgot to show you how they look on the graph. As you remember, we stored all the data in our new data frame. Let's read it. In our data frame, the column DIR contains labels, and the column CROSS IDX contains the tick number when the price goes out of the window. I defined a simple function to represent open and close position events according to these columns on the graph. DIR is open event, CROSS IDX is close event. Here, the filled triangle represent open position event and not filled one represent close position event. As you may see, most of the time our open events is placed on the local maximum or minimum. For further work, we will use a small dataset like before. Also, I will split my dataset here on train, evaluation and test datasets. Okay, now, when we know everything about our labels, let's go to the next step and begin to work with TFX pipeline. Maybe you already know what the TFX is, or maybe not. Anyway, I will shortly present it here. If we open the TensorFlow TFX web page, we can read that a TFX pipeline is a sequence of components that implement a machine learning pipeline which is specifically designed for scalable high-performance machine learning tasks that includes modeling, training, serving interface and managing deployments to different platforms. Well, sounds exactly what we need. I highly recommend checking the TFX presentation and user guides. From there, you will get a basic understanding of the TFX components and how they are connected to each other. All the links you can find in the description to this video. As I never used the TFX before, I will be learning it myself from episode to episode. And today, we will start from the first four components of it. The first one is ExampleGen component. It's the initial input component of a pipeline that injects and optionally splits the input datasets. The next one calculates statistics for the datasets. SchemaGen checks the statistic and generates a data description. And the example validator looks for anomalies and missing values. To be sure that I am going the right direction, I will use the Chicago taxi example from the TensorFlow team as a template. The example demonstrates the end-to-end workflow and steps of how to analyze, validate and transform data, how to train a model and serve it. Now, let's switch to our data. After we import all required modules and send all variables which contain input and output data folders, we can try to load our data into the pipeline. Our input folder contains evaluation, train and test subfolders with corresponding datasets. It should be a very simple step to use ExampleGen. It consumes external files to generate examples which will be read by other TFX components. But it looks like that ExampleGen doesn't support custom time series splits. For this reason, I have to split the data manually into the train, evaluation and test datasets. Unfortunately, by default, it splits the data into the train and evaluation only. And it seems that at the moment the TFX component are working only with this default split. As I said earlier, we can split the data manually and set our own input split configuration. So, that ExampleGen will generate the output split one-to-one to input mapping. As you can see, the result output of ExampleGen consists of two artifacts, train and evaluation. We can check for example, first three elements of our training set. As you can see, this is the same dataset as we have earlier. The next step should go smoothly. We put the result from the ExampleGen components into the StatisticsGen. As the output, we also get two artifacts that contain the dataset statistics. Now the magic begins. In one command line we can represent all the statistics graphically. Here we can see the statistic of trained dataset. For example, the data distribution, standard deviation, how many missing values we have, and so on. The same set of statistics you can see for evaluation set. The statistic shows that we have only 2% of our labels that are not equal to 0. It could mean that our entry events of profitable trades are outliers, and we are going to find them. Also, it could give us a problem in the future, because we have unbalanced classes. The next step is the generation of the data schema. We will generate the schema automatically, basing on the statistics output. But we also could define our own input data description if we want. As the output, we receive a data description of our data. And the last component for today is the example validator. The component validates the data basing on the statistics and the schema. And if we have anomalies in our data, it will show it to us. Just like in the Chicago taxi example, where the feature company has an unexpected string value. As you can see, in our case we don't have any anomalies in our dataset. Well, it was a quick start with the TFX. In the next videos, we will go further through the other TFX components and see how to transform our data and train our model. See you in the next video. Bye!